I was given a summary of comments made by former student mayors to help me draft some comments of my own for this evening. And of course, while I echo the sentiments of gratitude made by all of my predecessors, the fact is, you've heard it all before. So I began to think about what I could say to you today that might actually make a difference to the city of Barrie. Therefore, I would like to briefly mention two ideas that came to mind as I sat in council over the past 2 weeks. At the last council meeting, one of the items on the agenda was the youth vandalism that occurred on St. Patrick's Day. It occurred to me that most of the issues discussed in council either involve or affect youth in some way. Therefore, I'd like to propose the creation of something like a student mayor youth advisory committee, comprised of former student mayors, to advise the council on regular items, agenda items, pertaining to youth. For example, a similar committee might have been able to advise the council last week on creative strategies to mitigate youth violence and vandalism in the future, or to determine what triggered the vandalism on that day. Secondly, last year I was on a CBC News television program talking about the importance of science to the future of Canada's youth, and that gave me a great idea. As a former Canada-wide Science Fair winner, I thought that the City of Barrie should sponsor an annual Youth Sciences Day and invite guest speakers, like David Suzuki, to speak to Barrie's youth on the importance and significance of science. I believe that the many branches of science are not promoted enough amongst today's youth, and creating Youth Sciences Day would help bring them to their attention. Also, a Youth Sciences Day would benefit Barrie in many ways, like giving it a spot on the world stage, bolstering the Barrie brand, and indirectly stimulating investment from around the world. So in conclusion, like all the student mayors before me, I appreciate the honor of being one of the select few given the opportunity to sit with you on these last two council sessions and get a brief insight into the workings of municipal government. And after only listening to two council sessions, I have already decided that I would soon like to return, either as a member of council, or as a councillor, or even as the mayor, because I sure did like it when all of those around me had to call me your worship. Watch out, Mayor Lehman. Thank you, and good evening.
I'm just going to leave now. Thank you very much for those remarks, Maya Andres.
I'm not as prepared as Maya because I left my home. So first of all, thank you everyone. And my name is Andres Perez Lariño, and I am from Bear Creek Secondary School. And to the mayor and all council members and all people on the stage. First of all, I want to begin by thanking the Barrie Creek Student Council and the City Clerk's Office for giving me the opportunity to be part of the City of Barrie Council for these last couple of weeks. I was very ecstatic when I learned that I would have the privilege to be part of the Student Mayor Program, and I am very glad I did it, for it has truly given me great experience. I have gotten a lot of insight on the ways that the city is run, and experience the processes that occur behind the scenes when laws and bylaws are passed. I have always been very fond of politics and economics. This provided me with a great opportunity to truly understand how it works and has confirmed my love for politics and economics. So thank you again for allowing me to be part of the City Council, and now I just hope to continue my career in politics. Thank you.
Eighth session workshop designed to develop better leadership skills and better public speaking skills. With these skills, students can meet the demands of today's world. Our program is sponsored by the Barrie Small Business Toastmasters Club. And at the end of January, we held our final meeting. Our final speeches were on the topic of, if I were the mayor of Barrie, I would dot, dot, dot. Mayor Jeff attended our meeting and even signed autographs. But he also picked four students to come here and present their topics on if I were the mayor of Barrie, I would. And our first speaker will be Laura.
Mayor Lehman and city councilors, if I were the mayor of Barrie, I would add more tourist attractions to the city. I would start with a music park built downtown near the water. It would have lots of rides and games to play. There would be a water park with twirling slides that shoot out into the lake. The park would also have a section for water bump boats to race and bump into each other. There would be something for all ages to enjoy.
You today. My name is Zachary Woodland, and if I were the mayor of Barrie, I would make January 15th, 2013, Hockey Day. That would mean everyone in Barrie would get a day off school or work to play hockey. There could be ice hockey games all over the city.
Mr. Lehman, Barrie Council members and special guests, if I were the mayor of Barrie, I would make sure everyone had a home to live in and food to eat by making shelters cleaner, safer, bigger, and more convenient for the people. If you go downtown early in the morning, there will be people on the streets that would have had to sleep outside. In the winter, it's too cold for people to sleep outside. For example, this past winter, we've had freezing rain, cold snow, cold temperatures, and other unpredictable weather changes. I think there should be a spot in every shelter for a food bank where people can get healthy food. It's sad to see people looking through trash bins or for beer or wine bottles. Some people have to spend all their time looking for ways to earn money to buy things that they need to survive. I would ask for restaurants in Barrie to donate their extra food to the shelter and to the food bank. If every restaurant donated food to the shelter, people wouldn't be as hungry and the shelter would be full. I would fix the shelters downtown because the main bus stop is there and the largest amount of homeless people stay there. I would like to make sure everyone in the shelters are clean and in good shape. If bunk beds were used, more people could sleep inside. There shouldn't be any graffiti or damage to the buildings. If people need to smoke, they should not be near the building. Also, there should be no drinking or drugs. Barrie isn't that big, but we still need to make sure everyone has a place to sleep. So therefore, if I were the mayor of Barrie, I'd fix the shelters and make sure everyone has enough food. We need to help the less fortunate people in Barrie that most of us don't recognize. Philip?
Mayor Lehman, Barrie Council, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Joanna Vingo, and I am a grade 7 student at Steele Street Public School. If I were the mayor of Barrie, I would consider giving free taxi rides to unemployed citizens of Barrie so that they could attend a job interview within Barrie. Free taxi rides would be provided to and from the job interview location. Many unemployed workers have no personal transportation, so attending a job interview is a problem, especially if the job location is on the other side of town. Public transportation could get them to work when they have a job, but job interviews are a special situation. They need to arrive on time and well-dressed in order to make a good impression. On snowy, rainy, and dusty days, the taxi ride would assist the job seeker to do just that.
So congratulations not only on delivering your ideas so well, but on having such great ideas. And congratulations to you and the whole Toastmasters team. We have a small token of our appreciation.